Dick, they've passed their first test. The second round game, though, should prove to be more difficult between the St. Mary's Gales and the UCLA Bruins. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Bruins should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. First of all, work the ball to the interior to your post players. Let them be your option number one offensively. Second of all, make good decisions with the run. Don't turn it over, baby. And lastly, play your game on defense. Let your defense dictate their offense.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action and see what's in store for us. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
For two, doesn't go. Shows patience, waiting for the reset. On the elbow, down to the low block. Can't get the shot to drop. He tries the three. Way off target. Childers handles the pass. Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I'll tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help some.
For the bucket. In and out. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. The ball goes out of play. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. Inside. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
There's the fake. Inside. Pump fakes. Executes the baby hook.
I'll tell you, great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
A high screen. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Four undefeated seasons for the UCLA men's basketball program.
Unbelievable, Mr. Nessler. Unbelievable. Need I say more?
The power forward handles the feed from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
For two, he puts it in with contact and all.
The replay reveals the deal, baby.
Trying to pack it inside. And he'll kick it back outside. Turns it over. For the bucket. Tickles a twine. Definitely a foul. Yeah, Nicky's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Fed the low block. Blocked! And they don't score there either. He'll regroup the offense. On the outside, the shooting guard receives the ball, gets it to fall. Way out on top, controlling the ball, and off the mark.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
At halftime, the Gales trail by one. This one's too close to call here at the end of the first. Dick, do you have a highlight of the half?
There were some good highlights in that first half, but you got to look at this one. Watch how they got the ball inside for easy scores, which forced the defense to collapse, opening up the perimeter game.
It's time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how their second half plays out. Check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Pro makes a great move to draw the foul. And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
It's the second shot. He's got to move the ball. Cross court. Picks off the pass. Both teams looking to get things going here. Tries for two. They just can't find the open seams on the floor.
They're struggling to score right now.
On the outside. And he'll kick it back outside. That's a nice fake. Puts up the shot. The Bruins have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
For the deuce. Doesn't go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. The center with the ball. Here's a nice face-up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face-up and then just attacked the...
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. The point guard handles the feed. He shows the sweet touch. He attempts the three, tickles the twine.
Let's go back and watch that basket again.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Perimeter. Gave it up. For two. Can't get the shot to go. The Bruins are at the top of the ESPN polls, which means everyone else will be trying to knock them off.
Hey, at the top, you are the hunted, not the hunted. This means that you must bring your A game every day.
Rims out. Johnson receives the pass. Up fake. And he'll kick it back outside. He gives him the fake.
Nice high post screen.
Goes up for two.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. Paint. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
You're gonna love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
The Bruins call a timeout, and let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Might see a little different look this time, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
The point guard gets the pass. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Off the rim and no good. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
That's a high post screen, close to the lane.
Sweet looking shot.
He is super, he really is.
Get ready to bounce back into action here. And we're back to a two-point game. Looking for a screen on top and got it. Rims out. The point guard gets the ball.
Up and inside.
They'll work it around the arc. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Takes the pass in the paint. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here?
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling Brad.
Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. I don't even know if you and I can find a seat in this place, Dick.
I'll tell you one thing, you get the home court advantage when you got a crowd like this. By the way, you and I have the best seat in the house.
I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vital, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
Gets it. He makes his second shot.
This is where you really need a bucket to have a chance.
Looking for a good shot. from three-point range. No good. Way too late with the block. Goaltending.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
And yet another foul. One and the bonus. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Hits his second.
Gonna get a TO, baby.
You think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
So, but we'll wait and see, Brad. We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. They run it up into transition. All right, Dick, this one's over. One team moves on. One team's got to go home, and that's the sad part about the NCAA tournament.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bruins graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.